been in the country looking at a whole bunch of properties. Welcome, Tom.
Hi, Chris. How are you going?
Very good, thanks. So where have you been this week?
I've been to Adelaide, I've been to Melbourne, so nice parts of the world, so very happy to be there.
Good stuff. And what's the first property you got for us this week?
Okay, the first one we've got is in Kallaroo, which is in Western Australia. I was talking to the agent, Jeff Baldwin, and he loves it so much, he actually lives around the corner from it. Fantastic home. I'm going to auction this Saturday. It's got a price guide of $900,000 to $1.1. It is a really sought-after location, 4 minutes to the best beaches. It's a really special property, 900 square metres of land. And Jeff said to me that he thinks he's going to have good interest on the day. He's a great real estate agent, Jeff. He's one of the icons of real estate in WA.
Now, obviously a lot of people might think $1 million in WA is quite a lot of money, but I noticed in the advert it said that pretty much all the homes around there are $1 million plus, so you've definitely got to be in the right kind of streets, haven't you?
Absolutely, 100%. And I was also, I mean, what's really interesting about Perth at the moment, I was talking to a number of agents there today. We're having a problem in our newspaper business there because houses are being sold very, very quickly, Chris. So quickly that they can't have the ads published. So the challenge that we've got is that the market's too hot.
Have you found that we've had a client recently buy a property in Perth and the valuation has come in a lot less than what the purchase price was, and that's caused problems with finance? Have you seen that?
Look, I'm not close enough to it, Stuart, to be able to tell that, but I will check in with the agents and get that feedback. I have heard that it's happening in other parts of Australia as well.
Now, you've been down in Adelaide as well, so you've got something from down there?
Yes, in Adelaide, I've just spoken to the Century 21 agent. This is going to make Charles happy as well. He loves it when we're mentioning Century 21, Chris, as you know. And this property here is actually going to be on the cover of the Adelaide Advertiser tomorrow. It's right on the beach. The property editor has told the agent there that in her time in the business, she hadn't seen a house of this magnitude, this location. So this is special. Westlake Shore, great opportunity, right on the beach, 761 square metres. It's a four-bedroom property, and it becomes, it's a price guide of 2.9 to 3.15 million.
And I noticed in the advert here, it says you can have 60 people in the house and not even realise they're there, so certainly another party house.
A party house, yes. They did mention that to me as well. It's a great entertainer's house.
Now, obviously for some of the people selling properties out there, getting your property onto shows like this, or you mentioned for some of those properties, they've got front page of the local newspapers.
Yeah.
To create a story around your house and get the local journalist to pick it up, it's got to be worth it for your marketing, isn't it?
It does. I mean, it's really interesting because advertising that's not paid for, editorial, things like what we're talking about here, they've got really good consumption value because viewers and readers of it see that as that not being an agent sort of spruiking a property. And we simply don't have enough editorial space for the amount of people that want to have their property featured. We've got thousands of properties advertised in our papers every week. We can only have a couple of those properties featured. It's the same with what's on the show. We can generally only have two or three properties on here, Chris. It has high value, and you'll generally find that the vendors, if they've got their property as editorial, as people are going through the open for inspection, they open up the paper or the magazine and they have it sitting on the dining table so the buyers walking through can have a look and say, wow, look, this one was picked over all the other homes.
And again, you've got to think about that when you're buying a property is maybe you've got to pay a premium or you pay a fair value for those kind of properties, but again, when you go to sell it, it's always easier to sell.
Absolutely, and I always say, if it's too cheap, you've got to be very concerned because sometimes you're going to cop it down the other end because you're going to be selling at a cheap price. I believe, like you, Chris, that when you pay for quality, you sell for top dollar.
Exactly. And Stuart's nodding as well. When you've got your accountant nodding that it's good advice, then that's always a good thing. Good to see you, Tom, and we'll see you next week.
See you guys.
Thanks,
see you
man.
Later.
Bye-bye.
After the break, our thoughts on a viewer dilemma. You're watching Your Property Empire.